Royal Challengers Bengaluru managed to keep their playoff hopes alive by beating Punjab Kings by 60 runs in the crucial match held in Dharamshala. The result means RCB keep their playoff hopes alive with their fourth win on the bounce, while Punjab Kings become the second team after Mumbai Indians to be eliminated from the tournament. Kohli hit 7 fours and 6 maximums at a strike rate of 195.74 in his vintage avatar, which also took him past the 600 run mark in IPL 2024. Kohli could have been out on the third ball of the innings had Ashutosh Sharma picked up his catch at point off Vidwat Kavirappa. Following a 33-minute rain and hail interruption, Kohli got his 15-32 balls with a vintage flick through mid-wicket for 4 of Liam Livingstone. He continued to nail authoritative boundaries mixed with nonchalance and vintage stroke play to the delight of the fans chanting Kohli Kohli. But Kohli fell 8 runs short of his second century of this season when he sliced an Arshdeep Singh's delivery to deep third man in the 18th over. Kohli, who scored 92 runs off just 47 balls in the game, crossed the mark of 1,000 IPL runs against Punjab Kings and thus became the first ever batter in the history of the tournament to do it against 3 opponents. Kohli has already achieved the feat against Delhi Capitals and Chennai Super Kings. The win helped RCB keep their playoff hopes alive with 10 points to their name from 12 matches. To make it to the final 4, RCB need to win their remaining 2 games and hope for favourable results from other games. RCB batter Virat Kohli continues to hold the orange cap with 634 runs from 12 matches, while Punjab Kings' Harshal Patel has the purple cap now with 12 wickets from 12 matches. As RCB enjoyed a 4-match winning streak in IPL 2024, two of our people from Ref Sports, Trisha Ghoshal and Gargi Raut, explored the very famous RCB Cafe in Bengaluru, as they checked on the vibe and atmosphere of the place and also how the localites were reacting to RCB's late charge in a bid to make it to the IPL playoff. Let's take a look.
Hello and welcome to Rev Sports. I'm Gargi Raut and joining me today is RCB super fan Trisha Ghoshal. Actually, I'm also an RCB fan.
Yeah.
But I have to, you know, stay a little neutral.
Let's just be the RCB fans that we are, you
and
know.
Because we are such big RCB fans, of course we have come to the RCB Cafe. And
yeah,
like you can
first
tell.
Of all, before we start the show, when we had come to Bengaluru for our shooting assignment, the first thing that we had asked Borya, our boss, that, you know, you have to take us to a place where we can celebrate the RCB fandom. And no better place than the RCB
Cafe. Exactly. And now that exactly this is the right timing because RCB can make a comeback in this tournament.
And today is RCB's match.
Yes. What more important? But Trisha, we were talking about this. Okay, this is not the first. If RCB doesn't qualify, it won't be the first time our hearts have been completely shattered. Right?
You know, today morning only we were chatting about this, that what RCB will do, and we are used to it for 15-16 years,
the
emotional torture. RCB will take it to the last game. I think RCB is gonna win the next 2 games and we will all be hopeful that last game, whether we'll qualify or we won't qualify for the playoffs, and then you never know.
This is exactly what happened last season.
Yes,
as well,
I know. And I know, because I'll tell you.
In the very last match, I will.
You can actually go and ask my friend, because that was the first time I kind of had a fight with a friend of mine, because she thought it was funny to call me when RCB didn't qualify, because she didn't really understand that I'd be crying. She was video calling me, and I just cut the call and said, "Give me some space. RCB has not qualified," and she was like, "Oh my God, that is serious."
I mean, that is crazy. But when we look at the RCB qualification scenario, of course they have to win the next 3 games, but they also have to win with a very, very large margin. So it's not like they can just fool around, and they have to be completely in control of these 3 games, which is what is important and which is what is most difficult.
Absolutely, because we saw what they tried in the last game. So it's not like we are aware of it and we are calculating. The team themselves have that calculator on, you know. And Dinesh Karthik also said that, what happened against GT was, because the team was going for runs, they wanted to up the NRR. they went after the runs, which also makes me think that Gargi then, to make the NRR better, probably every time RCB now wins the toss, they will go for bowling first, because chasing actually helps you in getting the NRR up way more than, you know, when you're batting first. That also says that now the impact player, choosing the correct impact player, also becomes very important.
How was it to experience RCB Cafe in Bengaluru? Do let us know, and now let's check out how the ever passionate fans are reacting to RCB's stellar 4-match winning run in IPL 2024. After all, the fans have stood by RCB in the thick and thin.
Of course,
yeah. Like, how many runs are, like,
it's gonna be a huge margin. There are probably century incoming.
Okay.
RCB! RCB! You said I got something!